It's your boy SB Speaks, and everybody talk about communication and how important it is in a relationship, but very few people practice effective communicating. Think about making love. We're gonna just be straight up. Think about making love. How would you feel if your mate was playing on Instagram or texting while you was making love? How would you feel if they was watching TV and like into something while y'all making love? You'll be upset, like, why you're not into me, not giving me attention that I need while I'm trying to please you. You're more worried about something else. But I'm telling you, well, nah, it's cool. I can multitask. No, you can't. When you communicate with somebody, you got to give them your undivided attention. That means no cell phones, no TV, straight you and them. They looking at you in your mouth when you're talking and can repeat what you just said. So when you communicate, that means, hey, no looking on Instagram, on Facebook, or texting. You put everything down and give that person your undivided attention. That way they know you really paying attention to them. How do you expect them to get their point across or to feel that you even care when you're not even giving them your undivided attention? No, you can't multitask when you're communicating. You shut it down. Stop. If you ain't got time to do that, then y'all communicate at a later time when y'all both can have the time to sit down and let it be just y'all. If the kids is running around in the house, go outside. Go sit in the car. Something. But it need to be just y'all two. No distractions to communicate. Because when you start acting like you don't care and playing on stuff while that person trying to talk to you and pour their heart out, well, guess what? When you close that door, they need to get something off their chest. So eventually they're going to go to somebody else to talk. And we all know what happened after that. When you start letting other people be your soothe of comfort, hey, it is what it is. So at the end of the day, you to blame because you're not even allowing them to even be able to communicate with you. So you pushing them away. But then you want to get mad when somebody step out on you, when you might be the cause. Straight up. Let's be 100% real with that. And again, when you problem solving, you can't get mad and say, oh, I'm mad at you. So guess what? I'm not giving you none. You can't do that. Because what if that next person say, okay, since you're mad at me, I'm not paying the bills. Since you don't want to give me none, I'm not going to pay the mortgage. Or I'm not going to pay the light or I'll pay your insurance. And then what's going to happen? It goes tick for tat. I don't care how mad you get. You still got to take care of your mate regardless. I don't care if you're mad. You still got to do it. You vowed to do it. You chose to be in a relationship. You do it. Mad or not, you do it. Just do it with anger. It don't matter. But you can't sit up there and punish nobody or what you're not willing to do because you're mad. Because then they're going to go get it somewhere else after you take too long to come around. And if they say, no, that's their loss, no, that's your loss. Because what you was giving might not even been good anyway. So maybe they might have found better. So when you communicate and when you mad, look, you chose to be with this person. You be with them, you deal with it. You know, and I'm stepping on my own toes a lot of the videos that I make. But it's just being real. Real. You know, sit down. When you communicate, sometimes you got to shut up. Put a flag. I got the flag, I'm talking. The other person, listen and shut up. Don't try to cut the other person off that's talking. Listen. When they finish, you take the flag, you pick it up, and you talk. Because you can't communicate trying to cut each other off. The point never gonna get across. Never gonna happen. And you're gonna get to a point where y'all gonna start arguing, and then it's gonna escalate. Somebody punch somebody or call the cops, and before you know it, it's even worse. So when you really serious about a relationship and you really want to communicate, sit down, shut up, and listen. Listen. Let them get it off their chest. You say what you got to say. And for God's sakes, do not go to the past to make your present relevant. Leave the past in the past. Don't go to the past to say, oh, but you did this last year. That ain't never going to solve the problem. Start about what the problem is today and work on that going forward. Don't go to yesterday or what you did yesterday because yesterday done passed already. Never do that because then you ain't having effective communication because now you're trying to throw low blows and go back to the past. So that's another tip. I'm checking myself on that as well. And look, share this to your friends that want to be in relationships or that's in relationships so they know what to expect and what's about to happen.